your presidency have the special prosecutor's office, or you would have to replace with something? And if yes, what do you think about what we are doing now with the office of special prosecutor?
Office of special prosecutor is no different from the fast track court that we had before, isn't it?
But this one is...
And before we had fast track courts.
Yes.
Say Jill Chachuchikata before. This one, because we all supported him, because he was going after one, okay? People, we all cheered him, the citizen vigilante, force and blah blah blah. They appointed him, and we got anything from him yet.
Yeah, but I said maybe you are closer.
No,
you should
no,
be able to
he hasn't done it. He's been a disaster. He's been a disaster, quite a disappointment. You see, he comes and rants and rants and rants, and people think, oh, maybe he's about to bite. Then he goes back to sleep. That's the story of this man. It's unfortunate. Very unfortunate. Maybe he had his personal vendetta against some people. That's why he was talking so loud. Why is he out of the office? What did he do? Nothing. He hasn't shown anything. And I said it just yesterday. I said it on Star FM. Show me one thing that Martin Mudus has earned his keep. I'm still having hope that he can actually show something.
Would you advise him to step down?
I'm not going to make that statement. But
certainly, I mean, since
we will relook, we will look at his appointment and find out, we talk to him and see what stopped him.
But what the person for 4 years, assuming, hasn't done anything.
Oh, then certainly a new government has a right to reappoint and to resource.
Why don't you reappoint somebody who hasn't earned his keep for 4 years?
Well, that's what I'm saying. We will look at him, we will engage him and find out what problems or challenges he faced. If there were roadblocks with this government, we'll make sure we remove those roadblocks and have him continue his work. Diligently.
Are you uncomfortable saying you will fire Martin Amidu?
Martin,
no.
I have already said so.
I said I don't have the information to make that final decision. But yes, I'm the first person to fire him if indeed I found that he was negligent or reticent about his work. Or he plays some favoritism. Absolutely, you'll be fired. However, we will sit down with him, engage him, let him tell us what stopped him from prosecuting a few of those cases. You know, that's all. We need to see that. I know it was a controversy, though, and I heard Chrissy Pratt cheering me just this morning. Yes, I will look at him and say, I mean, I'm not going to say so because we are not in power yet. It's irrelevant for me to say so. But day one, absolutely, we have the cases. You know, the Auditor General. He doesn't have to do another investigation. Auditor General has all the dossier on all this corruption and auditing documents that has been done for 15, 20 years. What has been done with it? And the public hearing accounts committee revealing information. It's all on public record. So we don't need, quote unquote, a special prosecutor. However, since he's been given that mandate, he doesn't have... If he tells me he doesn't have the wherewithal or the mandate or the people, the personnel, to do investigation, then he's a liar. Auditor General has been paid to do investigations. Attorney General has the information and all of that, and legal systems are. Look, I've said so. Intent to defraud is criminal.
Yes.
Intent to defraud is criminal. So what is the story? Even if you don't succeed, you can still be prosecuted for your intent. So what? How much more do we need? How much more do we need? To bite on these people as a deterrent. We must have something to teach people that, look, you can't get away with some of these issues.